This right here is the tow pig for the season.
My truck is a 2011 F350 Lariat 6.7 Power Stroke.
Starting up front, we got the paint match grille, we got the paint match bumpers, got the Alpha Rex headlights, white LED cab lights, white LED mirror lights, Bilstein 5100s all around, Rough Country leveling kit, Hostel Sprocket 20x12s. Come over here, we got the tonneau cover to keep our gear nice and dry, smoke third brake light, Alpha Rex rear tail lights, and of course, the 5-inch straight pipe out to a 7-inch tip. If we come inside the truck, it is a fully loaded Lariat, so we have full leather seats all around, front and rear, heated and cooled leather, Sony sound system, navigation, we got a hill descent control, we got trailer brake controller, four-wheel drive, locking diff, traction control. We got all the good stuff on this truck, everything you need to make an amazing tow rig. So this was my towing rig for last season. Before this, I was towing with like a 2002 GMC Sierra 6.0 gas motor, and yo, that thing was hurting. Like, you could really feel the weight back there. This truck, it's like it's not even back there. As far as what I'm gonna do this truck before winter, I'm not really sure. I want to get a nicer drop hitch because I just have this like rusty little like junky hitch here. I kind of want to get like a nicer drop hitch. Might replace my bumper because this bumper is like honestly clapped, so I might redo my rear bumper and potentially might do new tires. I've had these on here for less than a year, but they're a Venom Power. They're like really cheap tires and they're wearing down pretty quick. Plus I've done a few burnouts on them. That does not help. Oh, by the way, this truck has 209,000 miles on it. I bought it with 192,000 less than a year ago, I think like 10 months ago. So I've put on like 17,000 miles in 10 months. Now we're gonna move on to my trailer. It is a older three-place snowmobile trailer, and I say three-place, it's really a two-place to today's standard. Back in the day when this trailer was new, you could fit three short tracks in here, no problem. But now with the long tracks, because I ride long tracks, you could fit two of them in here and that's gonna be about it. So when I got this trailer, it was in extremely rough shape. I paid literally $500 for this trailer and it was junk, man. Like, it was absolutely clapped. What I've done to the trailer is I've replaced the jack, I've replaced the tongue, replaced the chains. It has all new wiring for the trailer lights. It has brand new LED trailer lights all around. My wheels obviously are clapped. I'm gonna go ahead and, I don't know, maybe get new wheels or possibly sand these down and paint them so it doesn't look so junky. Come over here, the ramp is it's not in the best of shape, but it's actually not too bad compared to what the deck was when I got it. When I got the deck was completely rotted out. Like, it was sketchy to even haul a sled in here. So I went ahead and replaced the entire deck with marine grade plywood. As you can see, there's my sled in there, my dad's snowblowers, and the little kitty cat. My other sled is in my dad's trailer, so I only have mine in here right now. We got these lights up here that actually don't work. So I'm thinking maybe over the fall when it gets a little cooler out, I'm gonna go ahead and throw some LED lights up in here and try to wire them in and make them work. Also, up in this V-nose here, I want to put a cabinet. So I have the drop down front ramp here, but it doesn't really work right now. The weld snaps. So if you put this door down, it pretty much falls off the trailer. So I'm debating if I want to get this fixed and use it like it's supposed to be used, or if I want to go ahead and build a shelf here to put oil, tools, gear, all that other stuff. I'm thinking I'm going to go ahead and do that just because I kind of want to have like a nice little storage shelf in here. I went ahead and put like, I think 12 of these tie down hooks in too. So I got tie down hooks all through here. So you could literally tie down anything in this trailer. Now when I got the trailer, these sidewalls were rotted away down here at the base. So what I went ahead and did was drilled holes through the entire sidewall, put these brand new bolts in here, then put a piece of 1x4 here with bolts and sunk it up. And since then it has not leaked. Had to do that on both sides. And then yeah, you can see here, same thing. And then I ran a bead of caulk all the way down here just to really seal it up. Hopefully I can get this duct tape off because it looks kind of trashy on here the way it is. Actually, it's like coming off right now. That's pretty sweet. So I should be able to get that off. And then here's the ramp I was talking about. Yeah, this is like taped up because there's a gaping hole here. And then yeah, this is all bent and the welds down here are all snapped. So if you put this door down, basically the whole door falls off and hits the ground. These are supposed to be outlets. Obviously there's nothing. It'd be pretty awesome to have outlets here, but I'm not too sure how I'd run that. I'd either have to run it off the truck or mount the external battery here to run the outlets and possibly the lights on the interior. Another thing I'm planning on doing to this trailer, I'm gonna have like a whole trailer renovation series on the channel coming this fall when it's not like 95 degrees out and sunny, because I hate it like this. Is I want to put track grabbers and ski guys throughout the whole trailer just to make the process of getting in and out easier, so I don't chew up this deck because this plywood is actually really expensive. Also want to put those flip down ski guides here. They make ones that flip down. I think Caliber makes them. So when you hit this, it's not so jarring. It's more of a smooth motion. And I was potentially thinking about putting my YouTube logo on the sides of the trailer. Not too sure if I want to do that, because the guy I bought it from had these like Ski-Doo stickers. You could probably see an Articat sticker, KTM, and it just shows through on the black because it was just on there for so long. So I was thinking about covering that up with my own stickers. Eventually, I'd like to get a really nice four-place enclosed trailer that I could fit my friend's sleds into and just deck out with cabinets and a bunch of stuff inside of it for storage. My truck, I have absolutely no plans of getting rid of it anytime soon. I love it the way it is. I love that truck. It tows amazing. Like I said, you don't even feel this trailer back there fully loaded. So yeah, that's my truck and trailer set up for the upcoming snowmobile season. If you guys like today's video, smash a huge thumbs up on today's video. In the comments below, let me know what you think of my setup, and also let me know what you're gonna be towing with for this upcoming season. Like I always say, if you're new here or you've been watching for a while and you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll catch you guys next video. Peace out. I've been riding, rolling, drinking, smoking. That's something I do. I've been hiding.